Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Ali Baba here once again. How are you doing, guys and girls? We're on stage two of building our website inside of Dreamweaver. So far, so good. No disasters, no blood spilt. In this one, we're going to talk about how to manage a site. We're just basically, this tutorial and the start of the next tutorial, just getting ourselves organized, getting ourselves ready, so we got everything, keeping it tidy. So, this tutorial, we're going to go to site, up here in the bar, site, new site. Okay, and when we click on this, this site definition box will come. And this is basically telling us in the first bit, what do we want our site definition name to be. Okay, so for this tutorial, we're just going to be really, really common and just call it tutorial. The next is, what is the HTTP address? We don't at present actually need to be putting anything in here, so we can just leave that blank and just that's okay for the time being. And then we just hit next. And it will come up, do you want a server technology such as Cold Fusion, ASP? We don't want any of that because we're going to be working in HTML. If you did want that, you could simply click yes, and then you could choose which server technology you want, PHP, MySQL, Java, any of those ones. But as I said before, we're just doing something simple today. So we're just going to hit no, I don't want to use server technology. And we're going to move on to the next one. Okay, the next one is, how do you want to work with your files during development? Now, you've got two choices here. You've got the first one we're going to choose is edit local copies on my machine, then upload to the server when ready. Okay, or you can have it set up to edit directly onto your server using your local network. The reason I don't really use this one very much is because, let's say you were doing this and then you were adding files to your local network, and you by mistake added the wrong file, you've just deleted the file that was on there. You know, you've made a permanent deletion. So what I tend to do is I like to edit it on my machine, on my computer, and then at a later date I will upload it to the server. Okay, so I will choose that one, edit local copies, and then it's going to ask you, where is this folder that we're going to edit? And I'm going to click on the bar here, and my folder is called One Stop Tutorials Dreamweaver, and that's it. It's inside that folder, and I'm going to hit select. Okay, so it's documents, settings, One Stop Tutorial, Dreamweaver. If you go to the website and download that folder, then wherever you put it, that's where you'll have to go and find that folder. Okay, so pretty easy stuff. And then we'll hit next. It's the same folder. It's recognized it from something else. That's all. You probably won't get that error. The next one is, how do you want to connect? Now, Dreamweaver allows you to connect to your web hosting via different methods. One of them is FTP. So you could set up, if you went to FTP here, you could set up your FTP web server address, your username, your password. You could put all that in. I don't actually myself like doing that. I'm quite a fan of using an FTP client, and when I finish building my website and I want to upload, I then simply can upload through an FTP client. I find it easier, I find it faster. It just depends on how you want to work. If you want to work through Dreamweaver with an FTP as well, you more than can. But like I say, we're not going to really do that in this tutorial, because after this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to use an FTP client where you'll be able to upload your sites. Okay, so for me, I'm going to hit none, and then I'm going to hit next. And this is just a general summary of what is done. We put the site name, where the folder is, and the remote and testing server. We will set it up later. And then when you've done that, you can simply hit done, and it will say, it's just, again, it's telling me I've already got a folder called that name. Okay, again, you probably won't get that. And you can see we've got our folders here completed. Okay, and this is with all the work in it. Now this comes in, if you didn't see that, if it doesn't come up, you'll see some little tabs here, little arrow pointing left. Simply click on that and then go to files, and you will notice inside of your site called tutorial, there it is we have our website called completed. And this one here, our website, is what we will be building in the next tutorial. So you can see that it's in there. Now, you can do as many as you like. You can go to site and add a new site. You can also go to manage site, which means that you can manage which ones you want to use. I have a lot. I work on a lot of different people's websites. So, you know, you can come in, choose another one, and get into it that way, okay? You can edit the site from here as well. So manage site, you could edit it. So on the tutorials, let's say any of the information was wrong, you could come through all of this again and you can choose the correct information. Okay, so that's edit site. Okay, this will always be here. This is, if you turn off Dreamweaver and come back and switch it on again, this will be here. So if it's not there, just choose from this drop down menu up here and you'll be able to find your site tutorials. Okay, this one's called what? This is called tutorial. Okay, so yeah, that's how you manage your site and break a brand new site. Next, we're going to be going into, we're just going to make a folder structure and then we're going to get started on the table. So this is it, we've begun. Is it that complicated? You've just managed your site. You just basically, anytime you change any information in here, it will connect to this folder that you downloaded. They are connected together. Okay, so if you were to, let's just for purposes here, inside of that folder on the outside, we're just going to put test document. Okay, and when we go back into Dreamweaver, you'll notice that it comes up in Dreamweaver as well. It's because Dreamweaver and that folder are now connected. So you add something to that folder, it comes into Dreamweaver. Okay, so don't worry, it's all pretty easy stuff. And then you can also delete files from this managed site inside of Dreamweaver by right clicking edit, delete, and it will ask you, do you want to, and you hit yes. So there you go, that's how you use Site Manager. That's the, we're getting past the boring stuff, we're coming on to building our very very own website. Take it easy, guys and girls. Any questions, let me know. Please leave your comments below or subscribe to my YouTube and keep in touch. Take it easy. See you in the next tutorial. Laters.